गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 8. सो टुडे विल बिगिन विद आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज नॉन मेटल्स. एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी क्लियर यू रिगार्डिंग मेटल्स, व्हाट आर मेटल्स एंड व्हाट आर द फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट व्हाट आर नॉन मेटल्स. सो एज वी आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट आवर पीरियोडिक टेबल इज डिवाइडेड इंटू 3 पार्ट्स, दैट इज इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ मेटल्स, नॉन मेटल्स एंड मेटलॉइड्स. ऑलराइट, and many other things that I've already mentioned you in the earlier your class of this. And the non-metals are a group of elements located on the right side of the periodic table, except for hydrogen, which is on the top left. All right. So these elements are distinctive in that they typically have no melting and boiling point. These are the, we are talking about the physical properties. Don't worry, I'm going to explain you further. It does not conduct any heat or electricity very well, and they also don't have the shiny metallic appearance associated with the metals. Like metals usually shine, but non-metals does not shine. And metals have high melting and boiling point. Rather, few elements, non-metals does not have, they have low melting and boiling point. Metals conduct heat and electricity, but non-metals does not conduct heat and electricity. While the metals are malleable and ductile, the non-metals tend to form brittle solids. So, in the first video of our this chapter, metals and non-metals, we have discussed that there are metals, how many metals were there and how many non-metals were there. So, in total, non-metals were 22 in number. So, out of which 10 are solids, liquid is 1. And gases are 11 in number. So here are few examples of non-metals, which and the state at the room temperature, that if hydrogen, like hydrogen is there, the symbol is H, and it's at room temperature, it is gas, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, and bromine is the only one liquid is a non-metal. Iodine, carbon, sulfur, phosphorus, silicon, all these are solids. So, as you can see, as we have already talked about, that non-metals are present like this. The yellow one is all are non-metals, including H, that is hydrogen. So, here are some few names of these non-metals. You can go through the video and you can write it also. These will be helpful for your higher classes also, just for the proper information. And you just to know that how many non-metals are there, you should know this. And these are the names, you can write it down in your book also. Hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, sulfur, selenium, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, acetine, tennessine, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, magnesium. So now we'll talk about the physical properties of non-metals. Before this, I must tell you that students, in the gaseous form, gaseous non-metals, I have told you that there are solids, there are 10, liquids that is 1, and gases there are 11. In the 11 gaseous state, the five are the non-reactive gases, and the other is the noble gases. You are going to study in higher classes about this. So non-metals, let's talk about the properties of non-metals. Non-metals may be solid, liquid or gases, that we have already discussed. Solids are 10, liquid is 1, gases are 11. So liquid is bromine, gases I have already mentioned you. So non-metals are soft except diamond, which is the hardest natural substance. Non-metals do not have luster, it means it does not shine, but the iodine crystals, students, it will going to shine a little bit, the crystal one. So non-metals are non-malleable, it means malleability definition we have done in metals, that it can be the property of a metal, of a substance, when they are beaten into, they can be converted into sheets, isn't it? But if they, in the case of non-metals, they are non-malleable. Same with the case of, they are non-ductile also, we cannot bond them into wires. Like we can do it for with the metal, but we cannot do it with non-metals. So non-metals which are solids and liquids have low melting point. Non-metals are bad conductor of heat and electricity except graphite. Non-metals are non-sonorous, which means it does not produce any sound when they usually clash with each other. So properties of non-metals, as you can see here, I'm just getting you the picture. We have already discussed about the physical properties of non-metals. just to show you the picture, as you can see here, it is sulfur. So non-metals do not have luster, they are dull in nature. So properties of non-metals, they are brittle. Non-metals are brittle, so they can easily break easily. And this means non-metals are non-ductile or non-malleable, that we have also discussed this. The other property is like they have low melting point, they have low boiling point, they are poor conductor of heat and electricity. Hardness and softness we have already talked about, they are brittle. So it is just an additional property. So non-metals are generally soft, for example carbon and phosphorus. Carbon you have already seen, students. Conductors of heat and electricity. Non-metals are generally bad conductor of heat and electricity, and for example iodine, neon, etc. So the physical properties of metals and non-metals, the difference between is we have already discussed about metals and non-metals. Now we are going to I'm just giving you just an overlook to see the difference between a metals and non-metals, just for recapitulation that what we have studied in the last two videos. So metals are solids except mercury. Non-metals may be solid, liquid or gases. Metals are hard except sodium, potassium and salt, which are very soft. Non-metals which are solids are brittle. Diamond is the hardest. Metals have metallic luster. Non-metals do not have luster. Some have a dull luster. Metals have high melting and boiling point. Non-metals have low melting and boiling point. Metals are malleable, which means we can draw into thin sheets, but non-metals are non-malleable. Metals are ductile, can be made into thin wires. Non-metals are non-ductile into thin wires. Metals are good conductor of heat and electricity. Non-metals are bad conductor of heat and electricity. Metals are sonorous, which produces sound, but non-metals does not produce any sound. So I hope it is clear, the physical properties of metal and non-metals, and you are clear with the non-metals. Students, what I want you to do, that in your book, take a sheet, blank sheet, write down all the metals which I have told you in the earlier video. Write down all the non-metals and the physical and the physical properties of non-metals. First, do one thing. Why to do it in a sheet? Do it in a fair notebook. Take your fair notebook, as we have completed the three chapter question answers. This will be your class work, that whatever we have discussed in class. So do one thing, that on the top write down metals and all the metals that we have mentioned. What I have mentioned you about the periodic table, how many elements are there, 118, how many metals are there, how many non-metals are there, that we have discussed, and the images that I have shown you, whatever you understood in that, write the name of the metals and then write the physical properties. In the physical properties, we have discussed about the two definitions, which is very important, malleability and ductility, and the properties, the different properties that you have done, that you also write it, explain it a little bit. After this, we have discussed about non-metals, and whatever you have understood, where you could see the non-metals in periodic table, that also you go through it, and the examples of also the examples of non-metals, which I have shown you, the different names which I have shown you, and after that, the physical properties which we have discussed, and this two difference between, please write it down in your notebook as your classwork, as your classwork. I would like to see this work, and I'll ask for it later on. All right, so hope you are clear with this. Chemical properties, we'll discuss it tomorrow, but I'm not going to do it separately. We're going to do it together, metals and non-metals, the physical chemical properties. Thank you, students.